welcome to a very special episode. Happy Valentine's Day! Woo! Now you might be wondering what's different.
I don't know.
Maybe you guys know. So, grab your snacks, grab your loved ones, because we are gonna play a very special episode, and it's gonna be a long one. So here we go. This is called Lucy, the Eternity She Wished. And it is a visual novel. Achievement unlocked. Beginning light. Woohoo! Didn't know there was achievements. The three laws of robotics. 1. A robot may not injure a human being or through inaction allow a human being to come to harm. 2. A robot must obey the orders given it by the one possessing control or authority except where such orders would conflict with the first law. 3. A robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second law. Yeah, that sounds like the three laws of robotics. October 12th. You, meaning me. I just want to close my eyes. The thought enters my mind as I walk down the busy street. I don't think that's a good idea. There is such a thing as vehicles. Just all the brightly lit digital billboards and neon signs, covered from top to bottom with 3D holograms. I don't think that's how things look like. Okay. Emitting various ear-splitting sound effects. They're all giving me a headache. Well, take a pain pill. I feel like it could collapse at any moment. That might be a problem. You should sit down. This is the display of the IT Superpower Korea. A constant and in-your-face technology underlines our nation's claim. There have been many drastic and all-encompassing changes in the last few years. And being a person who cherishes nature, I despise these changes. Okay, that makes sense. That is why I just want to lose my eyes. Okay, but you still shouldn't do that. Blinking doesn't change anything. Oh god, I wish it did. I blink all the time. Everything appears even brighter than usual. Okay, you might want to get checked, dude. You sound like you're gonna die. I might just be feeling a little off. You think? Maybe it's the weather. No, I'm pretty sure it's you. I decide to take a shortcut to avoid being overwhelmed. Okay. It's a place that will take me away from the blinding lights. Okay. I chose to take my secret path home. Shh, don't tell anyone. Programming chaos. Okay. Whew. Finally breathe a sign of relief after managing to escape the chaos of downtown. I half expect ghosts to pop out at me as I make my way through the shady park path. That's an odd thought. The buildings nearby are all filthy and worn down with only a few inhabitants around. It seems I haven't fully escaped all the noises from downtown. The industrial noises from factories and construction work continues to ring in the air. But that's fine. Well, I mean, you decided to live in a city, what do you expect, dude? At least my eyes can take a rest. A massive building on the side catches my attention. Really? You mean this one that's been staring us right in the face all the time? K Robotics Co. LTD. That's probably what it would say on the main gates. Although I've never cared much about this place, I've at least heard of it. They put out various models of robots, which are renowned worldwide. I see them on the news quite often. My classmates are always talking about them. They are especially amazed about their androids. What androids? Personally, I don't know much about robots. Me neither. In this generation, it's impossible to stay away from technology, whether I like it or not. Well, I mean, you could go into a cave in the mountains and strip away everything and run around with a club going, ah! But that's just me. I don't particularly care much about it, though. And I'm the kind of person who prefers analog clocks over digital. I guess I can agree with that. Pianos over synthesizers. Now that I don't agree with. Pianos I like, but synthesizers are awesome. Acoustic guitars over electric. Both. Both. Let me just say both. And finally, read people over androids. Totally agree with that one. Gosh, have you ever tried calling a bank and like, please hold? And you're just like holding for 30 minutes. You're just like wanting to reach through the phone and say, give me a real person! Okay, I'm done. I turn my attention back to the sidewalk. I continue towards the hidden path leading to their junkyard. Naturally, this is private property, so no one is allowed to enter. So what are you doing here? But this is nothing for a troublemaker like me. All the people that worked on this game. Ooh, junk pile. Lots of junk. Mountains. It is. The graveyard for all their failed experiments. Are you one of them? Are you one of them? In the past, I've seen small tin can-like robots scurrying around and taking apart various objects. Only the most costly parts are recycled, while the cheaper ones are turned into scrap. Everything here is automated. The guy literally is in a grave, like, a metal graveyard and is sobbing over trash. Like, this dude needs help. There isn't anyone actually watching over the place. Just a guard robot and several worker robots silently carrying out their duties. If spotted by the guard robot, the siren is activated. Sounds like you've done this a couple of times. I've personally never run into any trouble though. After a while, robots are fundamentally stupid. But technically, they're only as stupid as the people that control them or program them, so I guess you're saying you're pretty stupid. With that logic, even with the guard robot, as long as I'm a bit careful, I can sneak by without issue. This is where that big company dumps all their stuff. I heard you can find some real goodies from time to time. Only if you're lucky, that is. Pretty sure that guy from my class told me something along those lines. I've already scoped this place out on previous trips. I never had a good find, though. Guess it's just my luck. Or I can't tell what's useful or not. Which returns to what I said before, you're pretty stupid. Probably the latter.
Yeah, most likely.
Since my familiarity with robots is quite poor. Whatever, I didn't come here to hunt for treasures anyway. So what are you doing here then? This is only a shortcut home. Well, get out of there! If I walk straight through the middle, I can shave off almost 10 minutes. Wow. The reward outweighs the risk.
I don't know.
I might take, like, a longer route that's, like, 10 minutes longer. Not to get crushed by something that's huge and metal and might fall and squash my head, but that's just me. If only I could just ignore the loud noises and the no trespassing signs scattered all over the place, though. There is a reason why those signs are there, to keep stupid people like you out. I have no reason to care about the piles of scrap around here. Scrap. As usual, I quickly make my way through the junkyard.
Please do.
Otherwise, that crane's just gonna straight up murder you. However, today was a little different. Something had caught my eye. As in, something made you look at it, or the crane literally gouged your eye out. Because I'm not getting much from this content. A faint figure in the distance. Can't be sure, but it looks like a person? In a place like this? I'm just gonna make him, like, really whiny. A woman. There appears to be an unconscious woman lying on the ground. I'm gonna have his thoughts, like, really deep. And then his voice is gonna be really whiny. She's not moving. Maybe she's hurt somewhere. Or something worse. I start to grow a bit concerned. Had I just stumbled upon a crime scene that might end up on tomorrow's morning headline news? I have to find out what's going on. I'm going in for a closer look.
I don't like how you said that.
A dash towards the fallen maiden to lend assistance.
Wow, you think you're a white knight in a graveyard of trash. Good for you.
But wait. It appears I have been mistaken. It wasn't a woman lying on the ground after all.
Ah, I was fooled.
Ooh, creepy. I like her hair.
But something strikingly similar. Two eyes close, tightly shut.
Yeah, that's what eyes do.
Yeah, that's what eyes do. Sparkling silver hair.
I can see it. Like, it's right in front of me.
From a bar, you can stake it for a person.
Nah, really?
Its features are almost lifelike. And enjoyed. It's what lying there. That's what's lying. Error. That's what's lying there.
Achievement unlocked. Abandoned room.
Useless piece of junk. Don't scare me like that.
I've never actually owned an android before, though I've seen quite a few around me. They say that an android is nearly indistinguishable from a person just at a glance. That's how advanced our technology has become. To prevent confusion, androids are imprinted with serial codes.
Like, each model has its own unique number.
I spot the android's code located near its belly.
One question, dude. Why are you trying to lift her shirt?
I mean, it's a robot, but I still think it applies to the situation.
I blow off the dust to get a better look. It reads.
Still, I think consent is considered in this situation.
PIM-001. Number one. With a design that I've never seen before.
What, you've never seen DS?
Maybe it's a prototype. It looks brand new. If so, then what's it doing here? Maybe this is one of the failed experiments. It's caked with dust from head to toe. All in all, it's a pretty sad sight.
You're a sad sight, dude.
It also hasn't moved a single inch.
Well, no kidding. It's lying in the trash. I don't think it'd be doing in that whirling wind.
Looks like it's out cold.
Hey, wake up!
Curiosity is very rude. I decided to test it out. I do know that voice recognition is a standard feature for all androids nowadays. Assuming everything is working properly, it should respond to my voice. No response.
Hey, say something.
Still nothing.
Come on, they're gonna cut you open at this rate.
I deliver a light kick to the robot's leg.
Okay, now that's just abuse. Initiating system 1.
Oh, that is good. Upon contact, it starts to show a sign of life, accompanied by a collection of leaps and bloops, arms being to spasm. Its movements are quite rigid. The scene looks like it was plucked straight out of an old sci-fi film. Probably running on reserve power.
But yes, it's still got a bit of juice left.
Unstable movements start to make me feel a little bit nervous.
Her eyes are making me nervous. Forget her movements, her eyes are just so blank.
The light in its eyes have yet to return. I begin to spot a pattern in its actions. It looks like as if it's greeting me with a wave. You think? Try desperately to get my attention. I glance around. I hear a screeching nearby. The sound of metal being crushed.
Yeah, you're about to die, dude.
And probably those little robots doing their jobs. I can tell that they're close. They'll probably reach this place in less than 10 minutes.
Oh yeah? You've calculated that?
I shred this android into 1,000,000 pieces! Its existence will soon come to an end.
I kinda feel sorry for this thing.
I begin to sympathize with the robot, because I realized just how much trouble it was in. Despite being dusty, it's still in pretty good shape. With a bit of a cleanup, it will look good as new. Had it been thrown out, it surely still would have been in service.
I don't think you have a very good idea in your head, dude. I kind of see where it is. I don't want to know.
I wouldn't know what this robot was made for, but I wonder why it's never saw its debut.
Does this give any clue? Does it? Or are you just dumb?
All of the labor used to create this robot will go to waste. All of the sweat and tears poured into creating this robot will go down the drain.
Oh yeah, I'm sure that's why you want to.
Yeah, I'm sure. All of the cutting edge features it could offer will never be realized. As far as I can see, the little bit of tinkering just might half of me is staring at the robot in pity, and the other half is calling me an idiot for doing so.
Yeah, you're smart half.
It's not like I really need an android in the first place anyway. I've never liked them. For me to actually keep one at home and use it.
I don't like how you said use it.
It's unthinkable to say the least.
Yeah, sure.
And more importantly, I don't know how my father will react to this.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and save. Just in case.
I prefer classical music over rock.
Okay, your train thought just went derailed.
Classical literature over pulp fiction.
Even if
Unfortunately, humans over androids. Let's face it, I have no use for an android.
Ah, now that's just me.
Eventually, this robot will be scrapped and recycled for new parts. It's just like how
It's just like how herbivore, but
It's just like how herbivores are eaten by carnivores for survival. Only the strongest survive. That's the way it should be.
You're just not right, dude.
Alert! Intruder detected. Devin, been spotted by that guard robot.
The most troublesome one.
If I hesitate any longer, I'll be caught and taken away.
Gotta go. See ya.
With those cold words, I make my way out of the junkyard.
You're a real douche, dude. Just left her lying there. And I don't like your choice of shades, just saying. Dot. Ha! There must be something wrong with me. Ha! He did bring her!
Even while taking a great risk, I ended up bringing the android home.
Just, no.
It's always been a bad habit of mine to act on my own whim. I've already started to regret it.
Yeah, sure, I believe you do.
Dot. But I decided to take some time to clean the robot anyway. I'm really surprised though. It looks practically brand new now. I was nervous about cleaning it at first because I thought using water might ruin its chassis.
Just its chassis, huh? Nothing else.
But then again, I would have probably just thrown it away if it broke down anyway. It doesn't look like there are any glaring issues for now. It seems like I made the right choice of leaving it. Besides, it wouldn't make sense for such a premium model to not be waterproof.
Yeah, I'm sure she isn't.
That's not the problem here, though.
Yeah, for real.
I can't figure out how to communicate with this thing.
No, that's not the problem.
Hey, yo!
Where?
Its arms begin to play away.
Show me a trick. To be thrown away again. Just show me something.
Hey, that's called blackmail. Don't you dare.
Where? Don't tell me moving your arms is all you can do. If you don't say anything soon, I'm seriously gonna toss you out.
Where?
Ah!
A low out an exasperated cry. This was no better than talking to a brick wall. This is why I hate machines.
I'm sure she hates you too.
They're stupid.
You're stupid.
Especially the one in front of me, which is in particular, seemed to be a million times dumber than the others.
Well, you're a trillion times dumber than that one, so there.
I'm starting to get a little ticked off.
You're easy to get angry.
Why did I even bother with this?
Something you might regret. This old saying has never been wrong.
Dot.
Now that I think about it, it's probably just operating under reserve power. Maybe it just needs a recharge. That might do the trick. I start to get up only to pause thereafter. There's another issue.
Yes, you have this in your room, dude.
Hey, where am I? I supposed to plug this coin into?
Where? I've never used an Android before, so obviously I wouldn't know.
Maybe your nose?
Sure, just give her a lobotomy.
Maybe it was just my imagination. Its arms seem to flail more rapidly.
Yeah, because you're gonna shove it right up her nose, you dummy.
Perhaps it's trying to tell me that I'm wrong. I imagine the android with an electric cord up its nose. It'll be quite a sight.
Don't.
Then how should I power this thing? I examine the robot carefully.
Don't do that.
Maybe I've missed something. It's starting to jerk its bird. It's starting to jerk its body from side to side. It seems like it wants to turn around. A small compartment at the base of its neck. I remove its protective layer. Inside, I find what looks to be a number of import ports. Yeah. Bingo. What's his name? E-I-E-I-O.
I guess I'll try to connect you to one of these.
I drag out the cable from a corner of my room. Without hesitation, I plug it in.
Main system kidon. Sangon.
Main system activation. Success.
Body. A response. It worked.
Application kidon.
Initiation. Initiating application startup. Failure.
Stop anytime soon.
이름을 발음해 주세요.
Registering client ID.
소유주의 이름은 무엇입니까?
What is happening?
이름을 확인합니다.
Verifying name.
소유주의 이름은
What is happening?
뭐야? 그 대체가 맞습니까?
Yeah, that's the thing.
What do you think?
이름 등록 실패.
Verification fail.
And just like that, all was silence once more. It felt as if a tornado had just ripped through the scene. I mean, it looks pretty complete to me. I gripped my head in frustration.
Blah, I really shouldn't have brought this thing home after all.
Now you're just stupid. This is already the third time regretting it today. Why do I keep punishing myself? The robot is facing towards me. Its eyes still retain a vacant look. I wonder if this is supposed to be normal. But at least it has started to move. Let's save real quick. I decided to throw a few questions at it.
Hey, I'm gonna ask you something, so listen up and try to answer. You can do that, right?
Over. Its head tilts slightly to the side. I suppose it can move more than just its arms now. It's not much, but at least we're making some progress. Let's do this. Yeah. Talk to
the android.
So, what exactly are you?
Does not compute.
Don't you have a name or something like that?
Model name.
Features. I wasn't expecting those words from a piece of junk that could only move its arms up and down a moment ago.
In short, your name is Lucy Valentine.
The android named Lucy is waiting for my next words. Let's try taking a closer look. As good as new after the wiping I've given it. It possesses an alluring vision, slender figure. Yeah, I'm sure it does, dude. Regardless of gender, I have to admit that it truly is beautiful.
Really? Regardless of gender? Are you absolutely sure about that?
I spot something on its left ear. A receiver? The robot has a of someone late teens. I guess they were trying to model it after a teenage woman. I can tell that a lot of effort has been put into creating this android.
You can tell, huh?
It probably sell for a premium price.
Hey, now that's not nice.
It'd be a waste to throw it away.
Yeah, I'm sure that's you won't do it, I'm pretty sure.
I take a closer look at the android's eyes. They're blue, they look strikingly similar to human eyes. As expected from technology, one whole generation ahead of LED lights.
Those eyes don't look quite real.
Suddenly, the eyes shift over to me. Naturally, I meet their gaze.
Is that so?
The way those eyes moved decided not to look at them again. They make me feel uncomfortable. I take a gander at the robot's moist glossy.
No, just don't.
Contrary to their appearance, they project a harsh robot of voice. Before advertising itself as a first-class model, I'd like to see if it's capable of changing its voice first.
Why? What's wrong with your voice?
What's wrong with your voice, dude?
현재 음성 관련 모듈을 사용하지 못하고 있습니다.
Voice box module.
Lucy Valentine은 기본적으로 10가지의 개성 넘치는 음성 프리셋을 지원하고 있으며 각종 이퀄라이저 기능을 내장함으로써 셀 수 없을 만큼 다양한 음성을 파생시키는 것이 가능합니다.
So, basically you have 10 different voices?
Don't we all?
Operation and outside of system protection mode.
절전 모드에서는 통상의 5% 미만에 해당하는 기능밖에 활용하지 못합니다.
Then how do I get you out of this power saver mode?
최소 20% 이상의 동력 여분이 남아 있어야 정상 모드로 이행이 가능합니다.
Long does it take for a full recharge?
제로를 기준으로 수면 모드 시에 총 8시간, 동생 모드 시에 총 16시간이 소요됩니다.
Yeah, stop being an idiot. I hope the electricity bill doesn't go through the roof.
Can't believe I'm talking like a cheap housewife in front of a robot. Twitch is on, I guess. That's just silly.
Forget about power saver mode. What's system protection mode?
Exactly what it says, dude.
During
system protection mode, virtually none of the included features are usable.
It is essential to disable system protection mode to allow
for normal operation.
Well, then how do I deactivate
it? You must
kill yourself.
Sorry.
That is unknown.
Come again?
No. You fucking pervert.
알 수 없습니다.
That is unknown.
어떠한 필요성에 의해 잠금 기능이 걸려 있다고 판단됩니다.
Under system circumstances. And you are one of them.
푸는 것은 바람직하지 않습니다.
Better than a talking toaster right now. I'm talking to a lot of toasters and I know how toasters talk. Do you really want me to throw you out?
I'll have to take it to a repair shop first thing tomorrow. When does that place open again? I'm done. I decided to take a look at the robot's ears.
음성 인식 기능을 통해 상대방의 음표, 음색, 음정음을 분석해 대상의 기분이나 의도를 대략적으로 알아내는 것이 가능합니다.
I haven't asked you anything yet.
I take a look at the body itself. Just stop. The shirt it's wearing is a little short, leaving out its midriff in plain sight. Yep, that's what a crop top is, dude. That's what a crop top is. It's quite exposed overall.
Well, stop looking! Gosh!
This mod was probably created to attract male customers.
Oh, don't even go there.
I can't spot any curves in the chest area, though. not that I care or anything. Sure.
Which ones are you talking about?
Deltoid anterior.
Deltoid
ridlet.
Deltoid
posterior. Pectoralis major C lavicula.
Pectoralis
major lateral.
Biceps medial.
Biceps
lateral.
Biceps.
Okay, that's enough.
What planet does this thing come from?
Yours, duh.
From now on, try to make things simple.
Stupid thought.
How are your legs? Can you move?
불가능합니다.
Negative.
What a pain.
You're a pain in the ass.
I'll have to take it to a repair shop tomorrow.
I think I'm starting to get the picture now.
First, the name of this android in front of me is Lucy Valentine. Second, according to the robot, it's actually a futuristic premium model. Third, as of now, it's no better than a talking tin can, like this one. And there you have it. The best course of action right now would be to take it in for repairs. It's going to be a lot of effort, but I guess it's not such a big deal. If I find out that I can't salvage it anyway, I could just sell it off on the spot. I was already doing the android a favor by saving it from the robots in the junkyard anyway.
While you are
full of yourself, it's not like I feel guilty anyway.
Okay, time to find a place that you can get next.
Shops, I've actually heard of one that's pretty close by. Some relatively new piece that I've noticed on my way to school. It's an antique shop, but I've heard that they also often deal with robot repairs. They also don't seem to charge a lot, and many say that they're the ace in business. I'll pay them a visit tomorrow. Now to decide where I should go. I guess morning would be best. Yep, sounds good.
Man, you must talk to yourself a lot.
I leave the robot with them in the morning. Pick it off on my way home from school.
I'm done with my questions. Try to save some energy up for tomorrow.
5초 후, 수행 모드로 전환합니다. 5, 4,
5,
3,
4,
2,
3,
1,
2, 1.
As soon as I finish my sentence with a sudden hissing noise, the robot grows lifeless. I groan, and as I reach out, the tinge is falling apart. I carefully place it against the wall and straighten out its clothes.
At least lie it down. Come on, dude. Phew.
I'm totally drained. I hope tomorrow will be more peaceful.
Saw this. May 3rd, Doctor. Well, that was a time lapse.
Alright, we'll save it here. Thank you so much for you guys watching this special episode. If you'd like to play the game, I'll leave the link in the description. It's on Steam for about $10. Let me know if you want me to keep playing this or just leave it off. Leave a like on the video if you enjoyed and subscribe for more. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.